Hi everyone, trust you're doing okay. Day 20, Tuesday 26th of May, on this blog of ours. Okay, just to say that in unfolding the things that we're going to look at regarding being born again, in the early days, a gentleman called David Pawson, a preacher, a British preacher called David Pawson, was really influential in our youth group. And we had tapes. We listened to tapes in those days, just audio tapes. And he taught well on them. And I think I'm just saying about him. He passed away recently, so we just want to honour him for his faithfulness to God's word. Again, looking, you know, taking care to get it from God's word, see what God's word said, and then share it. So we honour him, particularly today, as I'm going to bring something, you know, it's absolutely appropriate for me to say that, because that's what this is, where the beginnings of what I want to share came from. You know, you saw how confused it was for me to become a Christian, because there was nobody teaching me step by step the things that I needed to think about and understand. And David Pawson did that. Before I just get into that a little, we're just going to introduce that today, because I want to take a minute just to say the other things that he shared. We have said how important it was to understand what was going on in Genesis chapters 1, 2 and 3. And of course there are two accounts of the Genesis story. In chapter 1 is one account, and chapter 2 is another account. And David observed that if you think about Genesis chapter 1, When the writer is writing it, where is he standing? And David observed that the writer was standing like above the clouds, or, you know, in the clouds, looking down on the earth, you know, with the back view of the universe and the sun and the moon, but he's looking down on the earth. So that's his position to write Genesis chapter 1. Genesis chapter 2, he writes it from the position of being in the garden and looking around, you know, just being an observer in the garden, close up kind of thing, you know. Those two things help you get those chapters in perspective. And the other big thing he taught was regarding the abiding care of God for the Jews. Many Christians over the years have said that God's finished with the Jews, and the church is now, you know, the recipient of all of the promises that were made to them. They botched up. Now they've got all those promises have come on us, the church. And he would say, no, that's not true. God has not finished with the Jews. He still has purposes for the Jews. And he taught on that. And again, I saw the scriptures and I approved the things that he was teaching. But just coming to the things I want to introduce today regarding this being born again and an explanation of what's going on. He wrote a book on it, and the book had like four headings to the book, and he got these out of the sermon that the Apostle Peter preached on the day of Pentecost. We spoke about Jesus dying, being raised from the dead, going to heaven, and then sending the Holy Spirit. That's the day of Pentecost. So Peter, on that day, Peter, the disciples, the church was basically born on that day. And they exploded out of this room where the Holy Spirit had come upon them, and he set about preaching, excuse me, in the streets. And I'm just going to read a couple of things from that sermon that Peter preached. Very hard hitting was Peter that day. So this is as he's talking to the Jews who'd been around, and he says, "Men of Israel, listen to this. Jesus of Nazareth was a man accredited by God to you by miracles, wonders and signs, which God did among you through him, as you yourselves know. This man was handed over to you by God's set purpose and foreknowledge, and you, with the help of wicked men, put him to death by nailing him to the cross. But God raised him from the dead." That's what we've been centralizing our thoughts on recently, haven't we? Then the sermon goes on more, and then to the point that David shared, where he gets his teaching from, which I'm going to speak on in these next 3 or 4 days, I guess. The people heard that and they said, "What shall we do? What shall we do? We're responsible for the death of the Son of God." Peter replied, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus, for the and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus, believing in Jesus for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Spirit." Those four things become central now to our considerations, to lay a strong foundation, to know that we have engaged with those four issues. You know, then when you know you've engaged with those four issues, you'll have a strong understanding of that you have been accepted by God, you've been born again. So we'll begin to look at those tomorrow. I was going to do the first one today, but I really did want to honour David Pawson. I love him for his faithfulness to God's word. And if you want, maybe I inherited that from his preaching. I'm not sure, but I just love this word, and I need to see it here. If I see it here, you know, if I can find it here, you know, then that's really strong. Okay, God bless. See you tomorrow.